Well, there are lots of new faces that will be serving in the Michigan State Legislature this January. And joining us now is one of them, Coleman Young II. You're a state representative now, but you've just won a seat in the state Senate. Congratulations.
Absolutely. Thank you. First, let me say thank you so much for allowing me to be here with you. I feel like I've made the big time now. I'm Channel 7. Until it's my grandkids when I'm done. Yeah, it's great.
Well, it's great to have you here. First of all, let me ask you, why did you want to make the jump to the Senate?
I wanted to make the jump to the Senate because I realized that this was an extraordinary opportunity for me to be able to serve the public and to really be part of public service. And I felt that as great as it was as state representative, I felt that I really can maximize my potential to help others within the state Senate. You know, I believe that power is only as important as an instrument if it's used in the service to the powerless. And so I felt that with great authority comes great responsibility, and that's why I wanted to be in the Michigan State Senate.
We all know about the budget challenges and the challenges the state faces. What would you say is your top priority?
My top priority right now is jobs, jobs, jobs. That's really what we have to do. You know, I have created jobs or a culture of jobs through the movie tax, through the entertainment industry, through passing movie tax credits. I think we're definitely going to have to look at how we're spending in terms of, I really think we need to have our prison policy be in line with the Great Lakes states. We could save up to $500 million annually if we just had prison policies or prison incarceration, you know, years that we repealed mandatory minimums. And also, if we brought back good time, that would be $629 million annually. And I also believe we just got to create jobs, whether it's through alternative energy, you know, wind, solar, biomass. I feel these are things that we really need to do, ethanol, biodiesel, you know, algae, really using the resources of the Great Lakes in order to create jobs and economic prosperity.
You're a Democrat. It's a Republican-led state Senate. Yeah. How do you think you guys will be able to work together?
Well, I'm definitely going to have to work on my communication skills. You know, I'm definitely going to have to be able to reach out and work, you know, with the Republicans when I can, but also stand up for what's right and what's best for my district when I have to. You know, it's one of those things where you're going to have to lead with an iron fist, where it's going to have to be wrapped around a glove of velvet.
And obviously, your father, great legacy, served as mayor of Detroit for many years.
Absolutely.
What would you like your legacy to be?
Well, you know, I think one of the great things about my father was that he was for economic opportunity for all. And he really knew how to create jobs, whether it be through the private sector, but also through allowing people to have equal opportunity access to contracts. And I feel, you know, as a mayor within the city. And I definitely feel that's something that I want to continue. I definitely want to continue the path that he led, or blaze a trail like he did, that really embodied the symbols of, or the thoughts of, liberty, opportunity, and economic prosperity. And jobs.
And real quick, I'm sure you get this a lot, but any aspirations of wanting to be Detroit mayor?
Oh, I am so excited right now to be a state senator and be on Channel 7 with you right now. That's all I'm really thinking about. I'm just so excited. And hopefully within my new role, we create jobs and economic opportunity for not only for the people now, but for the future generations ahead.
All right. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations, and we'll be watching.
Yes.
All right. Thank you. Michael, Senator.